So this is one of those rare occasions in Southern California where I might actually need this hat. Good morning, everybody. So as you can see, I never really fully recharged. This is left over from my last DC fast charging session that left me with about 170 miles estimated range. Anyway, this is a Sunday and I need to go do some things. It's going to be a little over an hour to get where I need to go. So I'm going to find out if I can charge maybe on the way and still have enough time. I think it might be 8 o'clock or 8:30 is the meeting that I need to go to. So, or at least I want to go to. So I only need to see if I can squeeze that in. Otherwise, you know, I can always, charge after. But the reason I want to avoid doing that is I typically try to, time my public fast charging sessions around times that where the demand is the lowest. So that would be my preference. So we'll see. But anyway, we got to hit the road. So I'm going to clear everything out here just to have a good gauge on what the efficiency is. Thank you. Okay, so it's 20 to 8, which is about the time I expected to get here. The efficiency was pretty low because we were basically freeway speeds the whole time, and it did drop down into the mid to high 30s, and I was running the defroster occasionally to try and keep the windshield clear. So the efficiency wasn't great, but we do have a i3 that was parked at the charger, and there's only one charger port, so I'm gonna go ahead. It looks like they're done though, so I'm gonna go ahead and plug in. All right, got myself turned around. So I'm gonna go ahead and use this. Like I said, there's only one CHAdeMO on the other one. I'm sure EVgo is going to, stop making the CHAdeMO only stations. Let's see. Should always do this before. But for now, there's still something you have to account for. The main reason I'm using this location right now is one, the battery is warm, so I know I should get close to my fastest charge rates. But two, I'm not a huge fan of putting DC fast chargers at malls. All right, yeah, and I was down to 21%. Because this is fine during off-peak hours. So I guess maybe if you had it near the highway, it's okay if you're traveling at nighttime and there's the level two way over there. But during shopping time, yeah, this parking lot is packed, and anybody who has a plug-in vehicle, even if it's not compatible with these, will try to park here. So these two spots get taken up very, very quickly. You see it with the Tesla superchargers as well. The superchargers that are located at shopping plazas are always the busiest and always the hardest to get a spot because people go there for other reasons. So we're already charging at 39 kilowatts. Thinking that speed a little bit low, but I'm sure it will pick up in a second or two. Yeah, the drive down was kind of interesting. I'm glad I charged up last night just to top the battery up, but another sort of message that goes with that is, you need to make sure that your charge memberships are working. So I did a little video last night just with my quick session testing out the EVgo, because what happened is I was able to add the new EVgo membership, but I had to remove the other one. So I wasn't sure because I hadn't used the DC fast charging yet. I wasn't sure if the new account had taken. So the only way to really verify that is to use your card on a machine, test it out, see how it works. So. So I'm almost done charging for now. I'm up past 57%, but what I really wanted to check was to see we're at the 30-minute cutoff. And so part of what that new membership for EVgo, it's supposed to stop shutting off after 30 minutes. So it's supposed to go up to 45 during peak charging times, and for my membership, 1 hour during off-peak charging times. So it hasn't stopped yet, though occasionally in the past it has stopped, like at just under 32 minutes or something like that, 31 minutes and 30 seconds and something along those lines. But it doesn't look like it's stopping. So this is a good thing too, because it definitely helps with longer trips, because you can plan your stops a little bit better. You know, okay, I'm going to stop here for dinner for an hour, if it's off peak, you'll plug in and you'll be able to charge the entire time you're there at dinner, and you won't need to interrupt anything, use the app, try and find these stations, which they have the designations on them. That's how you find them through the apps. But yeah, so far it looks like there's no shutoff occurring, and I'm not going to charge up to 80%. I think even though I haven't taken this route that I'm planning to take back, it is a slower route, and I don't think I'm going to need as much energy as I used coming down here to go back. So I'm pretty much done with this charging session, and I'm going to head off to do what I need to do.
Because it was Sunday, I was down here to help out with the tournament, and this is why I needed to get to some meetings beforehand, and then of course, just do the volunteer work that I had to do. Luckily for me, the venue was actually really not that far away from the DC Fast Chargers at the Westminster Mall. So I just went over and quickly took care of what I needed to take care of, helped out, did some work, and there are worse ways to spend a Sunday. So all of that done, I had to head back, and so I decided to take the PCH back, or at least as much of it as I could.
All right, so that was fairly productive. Got to hang out with some friends, have some fun on a Sunday, and now it's time to head back. It's 2:35 in the afternoon, but the temperature's up now into the 70s. So again, that 3.2 miles per kilowatt hour is probably not the efficiency that I'm going to see. So I'm going to go ahead and plug in the phone and sort of see where it is, how long it is I can expect it to take to get home. But I figure I'll take the scenic route. It is a Sunday after all, and Sundays are made for Sunday driving.
Thank you.
Okay, well, that was a longer than anticipated trip, but there's quite a bit of traffic. I hadn't actually driven that section of Highway 1 before, so I probably should have listened to the navigation, which basically told me to take the 405 freeway up until I hit Santa Monica and then cross over. That probably would have been a better choice. And I also have never driven that Malibu Canyon before, so it was nice, it was interesting. It was actually shorter though than I thought it would be. So it's actually a much quicker route to jut up that way, but I almost should have probably stayed on the one for a while longer just to drive up the coast instead. But you live and learn and find new roads. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed that little weekend Sunday adventure in the Bolt EV.
And you're sort of the final tally for the weekend, I guess. But yeah, if you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe. It helps out a lot, and maybe helps to put more videos out there. So thank you once again, and see you on the road.